the rate of discovery is amazingly high now.
Nebraska is a water machine.
We're kind of pioneering the use of this crop for use in the future.
And I think part of that is the energy we've created, it's the momentum.
Nebraska's research strength helps meet challenges of the future. A team of researchers from many disciplines moves science from the lab to the field to the table.
So you're feeding the world with more drought-susceptible environments. You're going to feed the world in soils that are higher in salt concentration, and that presents challenges we never had. So the research dollars flow from federal sources. They come into our center, we develop new technologies, we hand them off to industry, and we make them really useful.
In the future, the food we serve our family will be tailor-made to guard against diseases like cancer and diabetes. The Nebraska Gateway to Nutrigenomics is a multidisciplinary study of the interaction among food, genetics, and health.
Our group does believe that many of these health issues can be addressed in a very cost-efficient way, actually, by dietary intervention.
The long-term goal is to develop a way of quickly assessing a person's individual genetic composition and then being able to devise a dietary strategy specific for that person. It really is individualized nutrition.
Researchers study the 100 trillion bacterial cells in the human gastrointestinal tract.
And based on what we learn from that environment, now begin to design foods that are based on the biology of that environment.
There is a tremendous potential to actually get something out of it, to develop the food of the future.
Nebraska has been described as the Great American Desert. But beneath the surface lies more than 2 billion acre-feet of groundwater. Nebraska has the largest number of irrigated farmland acres in the nation and ranks 10th in stream miles.
It's absolutely right to investigate these systems so we appreciate them more and we can manage them efficiently and wisely so we don't overexploit them for either quantity or quality, and we have a stable future.
Because of the state's vast resources, the University of Nebraska-Lincoln has a strong history of water research. UNL shares its expertise with students, citizens, and policymakers.
Think about hundreds of these sensors that are deployed in a field that gather information.
Engineers and computer scientists are working on wireless underground sensor networks that tell irrigation systems when and where to water and how much.
Our goal eventually is to make the soil tell us what to do instead of trying to guess.
The next generation of water scientists is trained at UNL. Graduate students in the new program study resilience and adaptive management strategies for stressed watersheds in the United States and Europe.
And so students, as they might grapple with problems of how to manage climate change and climate variability, agricultural water use and so forth, will be exposed not only to what are the scientific questions, but also what are the policy and legal aspects that sort of govern it.
Nebraska's experience helps write the book on water policy. Experts inform governments on issues of water rights and help balance competing uses such as conservation and agriculture.
Nebraska is a good laboratory for the rest of the world. That is, the problems of Nebraska are really the problems of the world.
Experts reach out to the world through the Global Water for Food Institute being established by the University of Nebraska. Science powers the future with research to find alternative energy sources. The Nebraska Center for Energy Sciences Research is dedicated to energy conservation and development of sustainable energy sources. The Nebraska Public Power District shows its commitment to research by renewing funding for the center.
We've been able to create this incredible pool of human resource that can serve both industry and education over the long term in an area that's critical for our long-term economic viability.
Researchers at the University of Nebraska-Lincoln work to replace the nation's aging power grid with one that better accommodates alternatives like solar and wind energy.
The goal of the smart grid actually is to provide better electricity service, to provide more affordable, sustainable, cost-effective, reliable service to consumers.
A native prairie grass will someday fuel our cars. Converting switchgrass to ethanol yields 5 times more energy than it takes to grow, harvest, and process it.
And so this is a crop that we can use to grow our own energy.
UNL physicists study how spinning electrons bounce off atoms. The goal? Faster computers and energy-saving light bulbs.
It turns out that by modeling these kinds of atomic collisions in light bulbs, we can make light bulbs more efficient. And therefore burn less oil, use less oil.
Economic development, education, and facility improvements secure Nebraska's future. Rural schools in Nebraska and across the U.S. get support from the National Center for Research on Rural Education, the only one of its kind in the country.
We are very interested in identifying ways to support teachers as they continue to want to learn about new strategies, new approaches. So Nebraska will become really very much the heart of where not only the cutting edge research is happening in the area of rural education, but we will become the place where people will look to learn about these strategies.
An effort to increase women faculty gets a boost from Advance Nebraska. The goal of the program is to recruit, promote, and retain female faculty in science, technology, engineering, and mathematics.
Diversity gives you a breadth of intellectual and technical capacity that you wouldn't have otherwise. It's different points of views, it's different training from what we're already doing here at UNL, so it really expands our expertise and makes us better.
The Hubbard Rhino Barn preserves 12 million year old animal skeletons at Ashfall Fossil Beds State Park, part of the University of Nebraska State Museum.
Our hope and our intent is to preserve this fossil bed intact for future generations, and each summer we'll uncover more of it.
Top-notch research facilities drive Nebraska's economy, provide training and jobs for students, and enhance quality of life. UNL leveraged investments by Nebraska taxpayers and took advantage of federal stimulus dollars to construct new buildings. A new physical science building, an adjacent nanoscience metrology research facility, in addition to the Morrison Center, home of the Nebraska Center for Virology, and the renovation of the Whittier Building, which houses the Nebraska Center for Energy Sciences Research and the Nebraska Transportation Center. From its Nebraska home, the Transportation Center shares its expertise around the world and co-sponsored a workshop in intelligent transportation design in India. Innovation Campus capitalizes on Nebraska's research strength to benefit future generations.
The vision for Innovation Campus is to position the University of Nebraska-Lincoln's research so that it will be attractive to private sector companies who will want to come and locate in Nebraska to interact with our scientists, to interact with our students, to participate in joint research.
It's going to be in getting them to want to invest in Nebraska. I think that's going to be the future. Nebraska's economy is very much going to live off of the successes we put in place now.